Hello my friends! In today's video, I am responding to a viewer's comment where they asked me to show them how to paint a snowflake. We have here our gradient background. We are going to cover this in thousands of sprinkles that will serve as the background snow for our centerpiece snowflake. For this technique, you water down your paint. You load it to your brush and tap it with your finger, letting the sprinkle fly where they want to. The other method you see me using here is to rub your finger throughout your brush, creating random splashes. To get a perfect circle, you can either use a compass or, as I'm using here, a lid. Our next step is to divide the circle in 6 equal parts. To do this, you first measure the distance from the center to the exterior. For my circle, that distance is 2 inches. Now using the ruler, I will place a mark every 2 inches around the circle. Fun fact, even though it is said that no two snowflakes are exactly alike, every snowflake has 6 sides or points. This is due to the way the water molecule crystallizes. Next, I draw a line connecting the dots. After I have my line, I erase the outside of the circle as I no longer need it. Now that we have a circle divided into 6 equal parts, we will paint our snowflake. From here on, I will use only one brush. The fine detail brush. I am measuring on each side 1/2 inch and I will use this mark later on. Inside each part, I will paint 6 more shorter lines. This will create a decorative snowflake. On top of each shorter line, I will paint a spear-like oval shape. As I paint on, I will try to work as symmetrical as possible, but little differences are going to add unicity and personality to my painting. So don't avoid the differences. These parts are similar, but they're not identical. Placing 2 dots on each shorter line. I measure the distances before so I can place them at the same level. And I will add more color to make the line thicker. So I'll put more paint on top. I'm covering everything with a light blue. The reason why I am doing it is because later on I will place white highlights and I want to create a distinction in between light blue background and the highlights. Remember the little mark that I placed a while ago? Now that will help me to place the flower petals. I'm trying to get as close as possible to the small lines without overlapping it. So I will leave a little distance between the petal and the lines. And then I am filling each petal with the same light blue that I used before. On top of the long lines, I will do again the oval spear shape. And I will put 2 V shapes on each side. I'm going to put one small and one long. And I will repeat the same pattern on each part. The small V and the long V. And this will merge into the petal that I drew in before. As I stated before, it's important to repeat the pattern on each side, but of course not identical. That's why before starting to paint, we will have to do the measurements. Yeah, I know, we have to do a little math, and we have to mark the starting point and the ending point for each V, so they can look alike, but not identical. I am doing the pattern. I'm applying more light blue here. And now I am painting the last part with the small V and the long V. Now, for the small lines, I will create only one V shape. And I will put this V-shape inside. And this will decorate our snowflake. We'll repeat the same pattern on each one of the parts. With white, I will do the highlights. And I will begin by repainting the lines that I did before. I'm using only the tip of the brush with a little pressure. On the longer parts for the top sphere, I will contour the inside, and for the exterior, I'm doing a curvy contour. I'm placing it on one side first, and then I will work on the other side. I will come with several layers of white in order to make sure that I have the proper amount of white in place. For the small V shape, I will contour the interior. I will go over it several times again to make sure that the shape is right and then that the brightness is also in place. And I will complete this with a few little lines on the inside. For the big shape, I am contouring the exterior and I'm adding the decorative lines on the inside. I will repeat the same pattern for each of the parts. And I'm putting more accents on. For the petals, I will do a three-layer contour. On the outside, I will put one contour and two more on the inside. And I am doing the same thing on each of the six petals. I am enhancing the center of the flake, and a little later I will put more accents on the major lines, and this will bring more brightness. For the small parts, I redraw the dots, the two little dots that we did before. For the spear, I am placing the curvy line on the inside. And the same as before, I'm going to contour the exterior. I am adding more accents to the petals. I am redoing the contour, adding more brightness on the center. And with water, I will blend everything. After it's dry, I am placing my final highlights on the petals, and I'm going once more over the contour, adding accent where I feel that it needs more brightness. And this is my frozen snowflake. Give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, leave me a comment, tell me what would you like to see me paint. And don't forget to visit my website at mgartgallery.co. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.